words of wisdom and use them the way it says, it'll be in our behalf. Everything will come out better. You know, it's not saying that we're not going to have hard times and different things come against us. It says that that's the way he wants us to do it. He don't want everybody to just slide through life and everybody get the jello. He wants everybody to feel the bumps on the road and know that there's tumbles and turns in life that we've got to face and take them the way we're supposed to. And what's it say? It says face your problems. When it talks about the whole armor of God, which he preached about the other day, it don't mention anything about covering the back or anything. It says face it. Walk into it like you're going to whoop it, because that's what you got to do. If you can't whoop it, stand there and take it until it passes, and then you'll be a better person for it. Because each one of these tests, at the end of this test, we can have a testimony. You know, that what we get through is what we're going to be. And you know, if we don't fight it, if we see it and run over here and hide until it passes, you're not going to gain anything by it. You've got to fight. I never was a fighter. I never did like football playing because I never did like getting hurt. But you know, sometimes you've got to stand. If you believe it, stand there and take it. If you've got to take it upside the head once in a while, and I tell you what, just right there in that nursing home, I took some cussings. Because you mentioned God to some people, but it brings up the devil in them, because he's in there so strong. And that's how he gets. He takes over their mind, and he'll take over their heart, and he'll take over their life. He rules their life. And there's not a one of us in here, I know I can speak for a few of us, that we didn't let the devil run our life for a long time. And you know, he's good at it. And you know, I heard a story about this old man up there at Crofton that died. They talked about how mean he was and everything. And it was two preachers and I think it was a deacon that was in line behind this lady. And this preacher told this other guy, he said, you know, she ain't never got nothing bad to say about him. I said, I'm going to ask her what she thinks about him. And she said, what you think about brother so-and-so? She said, he sure could whistle, couldn't he? He said, I bet you ain't got nothing bad to say about the devil. He said, no, he's in church every Sunday. And you know, he is. We bring him with us. But we got to kick him off too. We got to show him who we're here to praise and praise and worship him. And when we mention that name, that little old name Jesus, he's got to flee. He can't handle it. Because God gave the strength and everything to that name. So when we pray, in that name. Because that's the only way it's going to get answered, is in Jesus' name. Is there any birthdays or anniversaries?
We are sitting in Fountain Youth, brother.
Yeah, nobody getting old. You know, it's just birthdays. No, just don't happen in here. But
we get about one or two.
Well, I tell you what. One half of this do go here. Well, me and my wife going to have us an anniversary tomorrow, but we'll wait until next week on this one, because she's not able to be with me today. But I hope we celebrate a bunch of them. Amen. And especially in birthdays. Is there any announcements? Anything you know going on?
Nothing right off the top of my head. I just want to make an announcement about starting Sunday night service next week.
Did everybody hear that?
No.
Next Sunday, starting at 6 o'clock, we're going to be starting to have our Sunday night services. But I do know that, like I say, we've been in prayer, been talking about it for quite some time. I do know that there's several people that have been here, that the way their work schedule is, it's hard for them to come on Sunday mornings. They said, you know, when you start having church on Sunday nights, they said they want to come. And we decided on, 6 o'clock, that when we're going to meet and have our Sunday Wendy, then we got to go out and infiltrate different places when we eat. So we'll have time to let all that settle, and then we'll be able to come back and have church again. We can do it again. Amen. So just be in prayer over that. Like I say, it's not going to be just a one horse fiddle thing. Y'all know I got my pastor buddy sitting right back here as the associate pastor. We got another preacher man that's sitting right back here. That's why I sit back here with me. And I said, I tell you what, we can have them all day, every day if you want to. We're going to get it covered. Amen. Praise God.
Well, you know our piano player and our guitar player are both out this morning. And just have to do it a bit like we used to do it without piano. And you know, I bet we'll get through it and everything will work out just fine.
Amen.
God's going to hear his praises being sang to us. Well, we're going to move right on to prayer requests. I know the Gale family, the piano player's family, I don't know what's going on, but
lady that Jennifer works with, her name is Amy, but Amy and her son need a lot of prayer.
Amy and her son.
Keep Johnny on there. He's got 18 more trips. Treatments.
I did remember, I forgot back there. I think it was last Sunday that I let everybody know that a real dear friend of my mom's, where she lived over there in Redbanks, a dear friend of hers, Pat, real close best friend with her. She passed away, I think it was last Saturday, and then I got a call from her Monday as I was going to work, and another good friend of hers who was the director there at Red Banks where she lives, she had an aneurysm in her stomach and she died. So she had asked, you know, not only for her, but to lift everybody over at Red Banks up to your prayer. So they both those that passed meant quite a bit to everybody there.
Anybody else?
Continue to pray for Dan. And I got a message on Facebook this morning from a lady. Her name was Tina Wood. And I don't know the lady real well. Like, she used to live in one of our farmhouses up there, and she wasn't living in a good situation then. And she just asked for prayer to her, her family, her kid.
I know what. Is there any more? I know I've missed one of the meetings on Friday night out at Landon's Hope. And we had a good one out there the other night. It was a few people, but the boy had a good story. And whether you got a problem with drugs, alcohol, or have had, or whatever, you can come and listen. And you run across somebody that's got a problem, you might hear enough, a little bit of something that you can help them with. And, you know, we have a good time, they feed you, and it's just a fun fellowship time. I'll put it that way. I have a good time every time I go over there, and we've always managed to. There's always been a prayer said. Every time I've went over there, whether it was a meeting or anything, but you know, they help a lot of people. And if you get a chance on Friday night, it's going to start at 6:30 pretty soon, you say?
Yeah, probably in May we're going to start at 6:30. That way we'll give everybody time to get home and stuff like that. And It doesn't have to be just for addiction either, you know, if you're broken, if you're hurting, if you just need somebody to wrap your arms around them and, you know, you need just a little bit of love, you can come in and you're welcome. I mean, kids can come, because a lot of times we bring our kids to things like this now, we're not fighting the devil with addiction later. So, you know, teach them about it now.
Pray for this meeting and this group, that it grows and that it'll help more people.
We're also gonna have Kevin starting to come at least once a week and praying with different individuals that come in. We have a lot of people that come in and want prayer. So he's gonna start doing that, and he's gonna start helping, going to feed with us and ministering. So I'm excited.
Is there any other prayer requests? If not, we'll come to the altar and pray over these.